Hi everyone, this lesson is on the best and worst foods to eat if you have allergic rhinitis, hay fever, or seasonal allergies. So we're going to talk about foods and beverages that can worsen signs and symptoms of these conditions, and we're going to talk about foods and beverages that can reduce symptoms of these conditions. Let's first talk about what allergic rhinitis is. Allergic rhinitis is also known as hay fever, and it is a condition involving inflammation of the nasal mucosa due to allergens. So certain allergens, whether that be plant pollen, animal dander, or mold spores, can lead to and trigger an inflammatory response in the nasal mucosa, which is inside your nasal cavity. And this can lead to certain signs and symptoms, including rhinorrhea or runny nose, sneezing, and runny eyes. So if you want more information on signs and symptoms of allergic rhinitis and hay fever, please check out my full lesson on that topic. Now, I want to briefly talk about the pathophysiology as to why signs and symptoms occur in allergic rhinitis and hay fever, because it's going to help us better understand why certain foods can help reduce symptoms of allergic rhinitis. So what happens is that in a susceptible individual, an allergen triggers an increase in immunoglobulin E or IgE. That IgE will then bind to certain cells called mast cells. And when the IgE binds to those mast cells, the mast cells degranulate. And that means that the mast cells release certain cytokines, including histamine. And histamine, along with other cytokines, lead to the increased production and secretion of mucus from mucus glands. Histamine triggers the trigeminal nerve to induce sneezing. And histamine and other cytokines lead to local inflammation. Mast cells also release interleukins 4 and 13, which induce the cell infiltration of eosinophils into the nasal mucosa. And that cell infiltration can lead to nasal edema or swelling of the nasal mucosa and congestion. So this is the reason why we see signs and symptoms occurring in allergic rhinitis and hay fever. Now the topic of this lesson is that certain dietary choices can act on these particular mechanisms in this pathophysiological pathway to worsen or improve symptoms of allergic rhinitis and hay fever. So we're going to talk about those foods and beverages in the next upcoming slides. We're going to first talk about foods and beverages to avoid if you have allergic rhinitis because they can worsen symptoms. So these include dairy. So dairy consumption has been associated with increased symptoms and exacerbation of symptoms of allergic rhinitis and hay fever. Now it may be related to lactose, so a lactose-free milk may be a better alternative. And examples of dairy products that can worsen symptoms or that is associated with worse symptoms of allergic rhinitis and hay fever include milk, butter, ice cream, cheese, and yogurt. Alcohol is something else you also want to avoid if you have allergic rhinitis and hay fever, as alcohol consumption is positively associated with worsening symptoms of allergic rhinitis. So positively associated means that as you increase your alcohol consumption, the symptoms of allergic rhinitis and hay fever worsen. So they go hand in hand. And examples of alcoholic beverages you want to avoid include beer, whiskey, and spirits. Now, consumption of meat, especially consumption of a lot of meat, has been associated with worsening signs and symptoms of allergic rhinitis and hay fever. And this comes from the article entitled Dietary Factors Associated with Lifetime Asthma or Hay Fever Diagnosis in Australian Middle-Aged and Older Adults, a cross-sectional study. So increased meat consumption appears to increase symptoms of allergic rhinitis. Again, this is an association, so it doesn't necessarily imply causation. And examples of meats that have been shown to worsen symptoms of allergic rhinitis include poultry, seafood, and red meats. Bread is also another food choice you may want to avoid if you have allergic rhinitis. So bread, particularly white bread, may be pro-inflammatory. So because it may be pro-inflammatory, any inflammatory process like inflammation of the nasal mucosa may be worsened. So because of this, there can be increased frequency and severity of allergic rhinitis symptoms. So it may be best to avoid bread, but if you're not going to, whole wheat bread is probably going to be a better alternative. Now let's talk about foods and beverages you do want to eat if you have allergic rhinitis, as they have been shown to reduce symptoms of allergic rhinitis and hay fever. These include fruits and vegetables. So consumption of certain fruits and vegetables is associated with a reduction in allergic rhinitis symptom frequency and severity. So again, it's an association, but it has been shown that consumption of certain fruits and vegetables can reduce the frequency and severity of symptoms. And this has to do with something called quercetin. Quercetin is a plant flavonoid. So certain fruits and vegetables contain this plant flavonoid, and quercetin has been shown to stabilize mast cells. And we mentioned this before, mast cells will degranulate, releasing histamine and interleukins, which cause those symptoms of allergic rhinitis and hay fever. So quercetin can stabilize those mast cells. So that's the reason why certain fruits and vegetables can reduce symptoms of allergic rhinitis. And this all comes from the article entitled Quercetin with the Potential Effect on Allergic Diseases. Now, what are some fruits and vegetables that contain high levels of quercetin? Some of these include onions. So onions contain a very high level of quercetin. Apples contain high level of quercetin as well. We can also see quercetin in berries, tomatoes, and grapes. So these are all good food selections to eat if you have allergic rhinitis because they contain quercetin, which stabilizes those mast cells we talked about before. Now, it's also been shown that eating foods that contain vitamin C can also help with symptoms of allergic rhinitis and hay fever. So this comes from the clinical trial entitled Effect of Vitamin C on Histamine Bronchial Responsiveness of Patients with Allergic Rhinitis. So there is some evidence demonstrating that vitamin C supplementation can help reduce the symptoms of allergic rhinitis. And the reason that vitamin C helps is because it can inhibit histamine and histamine-related effects. So vitamin C acts as an antihistamine. So we can get vitamin C in a variety of vegetables and fruits, and these include broccoli, Brussels sprouts, and citrus fruits like oranges. And we can also get it from some other fruits and vegetables we just talked about in the previous slide. So eating lots of fruits and vegetables can help reduce signs and symptoms of allergic rhinitis and hay fever from getting quercetin and also getting vitamin C. Now, fish and fish oil has also been noted to decrease the prevalence of allergic rhinitis, and this comes from the articles entitled Eating Fish and Farm Life Reduce Allergic Rhinitis at the Age of 12, and from the article entitled Fish and Fat Intake and Prevalence of Allergic Rhinitis in Japanese Families, the Osaka Maternal and Child Health Study. So fish consumption in the first 12 months of life, so very early on in life, is associated with a reduced prevalence of allergic rhinitis. So as many risk factors for getting allergic rhinitis seem to occur in the first 12 months of life, fish consumption in the first 12 months of life is associated with a reduced prevalence of allergic rhinitis. So eating more fish reduces the chances that you're going to have allergic rhinitis later on in your life. And it appears that it is the consumption of omega-3 fatty acids like eicosapentaenoic acid or EPA and docosahexaenoic acid or DHA that is responsible. So consumption of these omega-3 fatty acids is associated with a reduced prevalence of allergic rhinitis. And we can get these omega-3 fatty acids in salmon. So this particular dietary choice is more likely to be beneficial in early stages of life, first 12 months of life. If a very young child is going to eat fish and fish oil, it's going to be better for them. It's going to reduce the prevalence of getting allergic rhinitis in the future. But it may also help individuals who already have allergic rhinitis. That's why I want to mention it here. Ginger is another dietary selection you might want to eat if you have allergic rhinitis. And this comes from the article entitled Prevention of Allergic Rhinitis by Ginger and the Molecular Basis of Immunosuppression by 6-Gingerol through T-cell inactivation. So ginger can modulate the immune response. So consumption of ginger appears to reduce and or prevent the onset of symptoms of allergic rhinitis. And ginger itself may have beneficial therapeutic effects on the nose and the throat when someone ingests it. So they can ingest it in the form of a tea, and this can help clear or be therapeutic on signs and symptoms of nasal congestion and other symptoms of allergic rhinitis as well. And then curcumin is also something else that you may want to eat more of if you have allergic rhinitis. And this comes from the clinical trial entitled Effect of Curcumin on Nasal Symptoms and Airflow in Patients with Perennial Allergic Rhinitis. So curcumin consumption has been demonstrated to alleviate nasal congestion, rhinorrhea, and sneezing in patients suffering from allergic rhinitis, because it appears that curcumin suppresses interleukins, in particular, interleukin 4. So as mentioned before, mast cells will release interleukins like interleukin 4 and 13 to cause signs and symptoms of allergic rhinitis. So curcumin seems to suppress interleukins. So it either suppresses the release of interleukins or suppresses the effects of interleukins. So because of this, curcumin is very beneficial for reducing signs and symptoms of allergic rhinitis and hay fever. So if you want more information on allergic rhinitis, including ways it's diagnosed and treated, please check out my full lesson on that topic. And if you haven't already, please like and subscribe for more lessons like this one. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope to see you next time.